I actually don't believe we have a water crisis. I believe we have a crisis in critical thinking. We have a crisis in problem solving. We actually have an abundance of water in South Africa, but we're not thinking about it correctly because we're locked into a paradigm. And the paradigm we locked into was developed in the 1850s, and it was a paradigm of scarcity. So because we have a paradigm of scarcity, we now have as an end result of that the water crisis in the Western Cape, because we've run out of all of the surface water that we've been chasing since the 1850s. And it goes back to two very important moments in our water resource management history. The first one is in about the 1850s, 1860s, around about there, when the first book was written about the aridity of the Western Cape and the method to solve the problems thereof. Some long sort of title for a book. And it was about how arid the area is, how unproductive it was, and the solution is that we now need to build dams. And that book by a gentleman called J.C. Brown created quite a strong foundation for work that was then done by a South African civil engineer who was working for the Public Work Department. And this gentleman went out and he did a survey along the Orange River. And he found out that the Orange River was an extremely dry and arid area, as we all know. And he found that there was a little community of people living on the Orange River, roughly today where Carcamos is, and they were taking water out of the river. And he created this whole idea of furrows and dams and interbasin, what eventually became interbasin transfers. So these two people, this gentleman was called Thomas Bain. You might know of him, you know, the famous artist and a naturalist, etc., also an engineer. So these two people created this paradigm of scarcity. So because paradigms tell us, help us to define the problem, they also pre-select a solution. So that's our problem today. Our crisis is that we're locked into a paradigm. And we need to pull ourselves out of that paradigm, and we need to rework the problem. And to rework the problem, ultimately, if we unpack what that paradigm of scarcity is about, we'll see that actually our limitation is only caused by our own thinking, because that paradigm of scarcity is based on understanding water as a stock, but water is not a stock. Water is a flux that moves in time and space. Water is the infinitely renewable natural resource. And once we get our heads around that simple truth, suddenly we're in a whole different space. We have this anomaly where Johannesburg, Pretoria is the only large sort of conurbation in the world, city in the world, that's not on a river, not on a lake, not on a waterfront. We're on a continental watershed divide. So we've done amazing things by pushing rivers around, but now we have the unintended consequences of that. And one of the unintended consequences is the fact that because we've pushed water uphill, we need to have lots and lots and lots of clever people to keep those systems in place, to keep the money flowing, to keep the pumps working, etc. We've lost a lot of those people. But now, because we've got lots of people sitting on the continental watershed divide, every one of them produces sewage and waste, and that water goes downstream. So we happen to be downstream of our sewage disposal point. So our drinking water is drawn from our sewage disposal points, and this is now becoming a national crisis. We produce over 5 billion litres a day of sewage in South Africa, and we only treat something like 20% of it to some standard that is reasonably safe to discharge. So we are drowning in sewage. This is part and parcel of our crisis. That's not only about Cape Town.